In a shocking turn of events, NASA has shut down the Voyager 1 probe after it captured something bone-chilling in deep space. Was it something hinting at a new Big Bang? Let's find out. The unexpected resurgence of this Voyager from the past raises exciting possibilities for future discovery and exploration. NASA launched Voyager 1, a spacecraft intended to travel outside the solar system, in 1977. A highly rare alignment of the planets in our solar system, one that only happens once every 175 years, led to the creation of the Voyager expedition. This arrangement made it possible to launch a spacecraft that could use the gravitational pull of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune to slingshot its way towards the end of our solar system. But what actually caused the Voyager 1 to shut down? Is there a possibility of a new Big Bang? Well, a magnetic highway was found by Voyager 1 at the frontier of our solar system. The solar wind, a stream of charged particles coming from the sun, interacts with the interstellar medium, the substance that exists between stars, to form this highway. A barrier called the magnetic highway allows cosmic rays from outside of our solar system to enter while slowing the solar wind. A series of cosmic tsunamis that raced over the farthest regions of our solar system were another enigmatic occurrence that Voyager 1 saw. Massive shockwaves that are traveling through interstellar space and compressing and heating the material in their path are what produce these tsunamis. These cosmic tsunamis' causes still need to be completely understood, and researchers are still looking into how they affect the region. The most chilling discovery made by Voyager 1 was the eerie silence of interstellar space. As the spacecraft left the heliosphere, the region of space dominated by the sun's magnetic field, it entered a much quieter area than expected. The lack of any detectable interstellar hum or buzz left scientists wondering whether the emptiness resulted from an instrumentation error or was a true characteristic of the region. Besides that, the Voyager also captured the ribbon of energetic particles that appears to be shaped like a giant bow or ribbon stretching across the sky. This ribbon is believed to be the result of the interaction between the magnetic fields of our galaxy and the interstellar medium, but its exact origin and properties are still the subjects of intense study. But why would NASA shut down such a historic and groundbreaking mission? It's crucial to understand that NASA has not terminated Voyager 1. Even after more than 44 years in orbit, the spacecraft continues to transmit data to Earth. However, as Voyager 1 continues its journey, NASA has had to make some difficult choices regarding resource allocation. The restricted power supply of the spacecraft is one of the important considerations in NASA's decision-making process. A radioisotope thermoelectric generator, or RTG, powers Voyager 1 by converting heat from the radioactive isotope's natural disintegration into energy. The spacecraft's instruments must be shut off one by one as the power source depletes, since the RTG's power output declines with time. In 2020, NASA announced that it had turned off the Voyager 1's Cosmic Ray Subsystem, or CRS, heating system, which measures the intensity and distribution of cosmic rays in space. This decision was made to conserve power as the spacecraft continued to travel further away from the sun. The CRS had already exceeded its expected lifespan by several years, and NASA determined that its collected data was sufficient for scientific research. NASA must also consider the limited bandwidth for transmitting data from Voyager 1 back to Earth. The spacecraft uses a 23-watt transmitter to send its data, which is then received by NASA's deep space network of antennas and radio dishes. Also, only a certain amount of data can be transmitted at any one time, because the signal weakens as it moves through the vastness of space. In order to optimize data transmission, NASA has devised a priority list of Voyager 1's equipment, identifying which data should be carried back to Earth first. This ranking is based on the importance of the research and the scientific merit of the data. Data from the magnetometer instrument aboard Voyager 1, which analyzes the magnetic fields in space, is highly important, since it can aid in the understanding of how the solar wind and interstellar medium interact. Hence, even though Voyager 1 has been kept operational, NASA has had to make challenging decisions about how to handle the spacecraft as it continues to explore the far reaches of the solar system. In April 1978, while it was around 165 million miles, 265 million kilometers from the planet, it started its Jovian imaging mission. Jupiter's atmosphere appeared to be more tumultuous in images returned by January 1979 than it had been during the Pioneer flybys in 1973 to 1974. Voyager 1 started taking pictures on January 30, 1979, and continued doing so every 96 seconds for a total of 100 hours. This resulted in a color time-lapse movie that showed 10 revolutions of Jupiter. The spacecraft entered Jupiter's orbit on February 10, 1979, and on March 1st it found a thin ring around the planet that was less than 30 kilometers thick. On March 5, 1979, at 12:05 Universal Time, at a distance of around 174,000 miles, Voyager 1 made its closest approach to Jupiter. After that, Amalthea was one of the moons that Voyager 1 sailed past, at a distance of 261,100 miles. The most exciting findings concerned the planet Io, which was discovered to be one of the most, if not the most, geologically active planets in the solar system. Images of the planet showed a weird yellow, orange, and brown globe with at least 8 active volcanoes that were spewing debris into space. The notion that sulfur and oxygen in Jovian space are caused by sulfur dioxide-rich volcanic plumes from Io was suggested by the existence of active volcanoes. Thebe and Metis, two more moons, were found by the spacecraft. Voyager 1 made its initial course correction after its encounter with Jupiter on April 9, 1979, in order to be ready for its rendezvous with Saturn. On October 10, 1979, a second adjustment made sure the spacecraft wouldn't collide with Saturn's moon Titan. In November 1979, it made a flyby of the Saturn system, which was as stunning to the first time. 5 new moons were discovered by Voyager 1, along with a ring system with thousands of bands, wedge-shaped transient clouds of minute particles in the B ring that were dubbed spokes, a new ring, the G ring, and shepherding satellites on either side of the F ring that maintain the ring's sharp edges. The spacecraft captured images of Titan, Mimas, Enceladus, Tethys, Dione, and Rhea during its approach of Saturn. The incoming data suggested that all the moons were mostly made of water ice. Titan was the target that Voyager 1 passed by at 5:41 Universal Time on November 12, 1979, at a distance of around 2,500 miles. Images revealed a dense atmosphere entirely obscuring the surface. The probe discovered that nitrogen made about 90% of the moon's atmosphere. At the surface, there were 1.6 atmospheres of pressure and a temperature of 292 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 180 degrees Celsius. What medium does Voyager 1 use to convey the message? Listen to this. The Deep Space Network, a network of antennas in California, Spain, and Australia, is used by Voyager 1 to communicate with Earth. Voyager 1 and other far space probes broadcast weak signals, which the antennas are designed to pick up. The communication system of Voyager 1 consists of a transmitter, a high-gain antenna, and a low-gain antenna. For close-range communication, a low-gain antenna is employed, and for long-range communication, a high-gain antenna. The data must be returned to Earth by the transmitter. Voyager 1 must contact the DSN antennas to send data back to Earth. The antennas must be positioned correctly and capable of picking up the weak signals Voyager 1 transmits. Once the connection has been made, Voyager 1 uses a radio frequency signal to transmit data to Earth. The radio spectrum's X-band, at a frequency of 8.4 GHz, is where the signal is being broadcast. Pulse code modulation is a method used to digitally encrypt the data delivered by Voyager 1. PCM is a method of digitally representing analog signals, such as images and sound, by sampling the passwords at regular intervals and converting them into binary numbers. The data is then transmitted to Earth in packets containing a small portion. The packages are sent using the Consultative Committee for Space Data Systems Protocol, a standardized protocol used for deep space communication. In comparison to contemporary communication systems, the packets are transferred at a pace of 160 bits per second, which is exceedingly sluggish. This is due to the fact that Voyager 1's signal becomes weaker as it approaches Earth, and the DSN antennas must be able to pick up even the faintest warnings. The data is processed and saved on Earth while it is being received by the DSN antennas. After that, scientists analyze the data and utilize it to learn more about the solar system. One thing is for certain, the universe, both inside and beyond our solar system, continues to astonish and excite us. Remember to subscribe to our channel to get the latest insights from outer space. Click on the video links on your screens to view our other videos to see more space missions like this one.